I got my heart broken so many times. So many times. I remember I dated this girl briefly in fifth grade. Last week, I ran into her on the street. She goes, "Hey, Eric, remember when I broke up with you in fifth grade because the nurse pulled you out of the classroom for having lice?" I'm like, "You mean the most devastating moment of my entire life?" "Yeah, I vaguely recall that." I remember I was so devastated I came back into the classroom and some kid next to me was like, "Eric, why do you look so sad?" I'm like, "Because Nadia just dumped me and now I'm all alone." And I swear to God, he pointed at my head and he's like, "No, you're not." I feel like lice was the first childhood STD. Right? Because you might only have it for like 3 days, but the reputation stays with you forever. You'll always be known as Lice Boy. And it's actually worse than STDs because they check you in the middle of the classroom and then pull you out in front of everyone. Could you imagine tomorrow you're at the office? That's the whole joke. Can you imagine tomorrow you're at the office? Can you imagine 2025 you're at the office? Two nurses approach you and they're like, "Pull down your pants right now." Then 3 seconds later, they're like, "It's crabs. You need to come with us. Your mom's going to come pick you up. Let's go, Crabs Boy." Yeah, the Crabs group. I love that. I was always scared. Were you scared of STDs? Obviously not if you got crabs. This guy's dick looked like a everything bagel. Oh, God. Jesus. I was always so scared of STDs, man. Like, my whole life, whenever I engaged in any sexual activity, the next morning, I was a wreck. I remember the first time I got a hand job. I was 29 years old. I'm kidding, I was in college, which actually doesn't sound that much better now that I say it out loud. Got a hand job. Next day I went to the doctor. I was like, "Doc, I definitely have an STD, no question. Last night I was unprotected." He's like, "You said you got a hand job." I'm like, "I know, she didn't spray Purell on her hands. Can you get it that way? I don't know." Got the STD test. Here's the screwed up thing about the STD test. Takes 3 days for the results to come back. So every day I was staring at my dick in the mirror. Like I never have in my entire life. I'm like, "Has this red bump always been here? I don't recognize it." By the way, the more and more I stare at my dick, the more I'm amazed that people have the confidence to send dick pics. I've never sent a dick pic to a woman. I will never send a dick pic to a woman. On the contrary, however, I've sent a picture of my dick to my friend Matt 100 times to get his opinion on whether or not I have an STD. And he always had the same response. He's like, "Dude, you better have an STD, because if not, I'm just staring at your dick for no reason. This better pay off for me." I'm like, "No, dude, this is serious. Do you have something like this on your dick?" He's like, "Yeah, I totally have something like that on my dick." I'm like, "All right, prove it. Send a picture of your dick back." Like, he's like, "No, I'm not sending a picture of my dick back. That's weird." I'm like, "Come on, please." Anyway. Later that night, I'm in bed with this girl and a picture of Matt's dick pops up on my phone. She goes, "Why did a picture of Matt's dick just pop up on your phone?" I'm like, "I'm as confused as you are. He never sends one back." She goes, "Yeah, but why is his dick hard?" I'm like, "You know what? He did raise the stakes a little bit." My question is, how'd you know it was Matt's dick at first glance? That's my question. And you guys have been fantastic. Thank you so much for coming out, man.